Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Oh! Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
By the way, unlawful rebroadcast or electronic transmission of this service is prohibited by First Amendment without express written consent of the pastor. Hey, if we're going to be like SpongeBob, we got to be like SpongeBob, and this is comfortable. It's more comfortable than with the robe that we normally wear, right? Okay, why do we like SpongeBob so much? Is it because SpongeBob is so good looking? No. Is it because SpongeBob is so strong? Can you think of someone who's stronger than SpongeBob? In the show. How about Larry the Lobster? Well, Larry the Lobster is strong. Do we love SpongeBob because he's so rich? Who's richer than SpongeBob in the show? Mr. Krabs. We don't love SpongeBob for all these reasons. We love SpongeBob because he's just so optimistic, isn't he? He's just so happy. He's always convinced that good things are going to happen, and that's because he uses his imagination all the time, right? I think we as Christians also talk about imagination a lot. Is that we use a different word for it? You know what word we use for imagination instead? How about the word faith? How about the word faith? You ever heard the word faith?
Yes.
Do you know what faith means?
Blessing.
It does. Because in the Bible, in the book of Hebrews, we read that faith is the assurance of things hoped for. That means faith is being sure that what you're hoping for is really going to happen. And isn't that kind of like using your imagination? Yeah. It takes some imagination to believe that God's going to do what God says he's going to do, right? And so when we come and we pray to God, we're using our faith, right? We're using our imagination. And when we believe God, even though we can't see God, even though, you know, the answer isn't coming right then and there, we have to use a little bit of faith and a lot of imagination sometimes to believe that's going to happen. So I would suggest that when SpongeBob talks about imagination, he's also talking about faith. And if we want to be like SpongeBob, and we want to be like Jesus, then we need to learn to use our faith.